When did the dinosaurs live? Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist teaching at Utah State University in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. In this video, I'll briefly outline the time period in which dinosaurs lived. First, non-avian dinosaurs appeared in the fossil record during the late Triassic period, during the Carnian Age, and became extinct at the end of the Cretaceous period. These geological periods of time were coined by early geologists based on observations of fossils in the layers of sedimentary rocks. Early geologists in the 17th and 18th century realized that there was a faunal succession of fossils in the layers of rock around Europe. By the early 1800s, geologists coined a number of names for each of these layers of rocks. Rocks which contained abundant fossils were placed within the Phanerozoic eon, which means visible life. The Phanerozoic eon was split into three eras: the recent Cenozoic, which means modern life, the Mesozoic, middle life, and the Paleozoic, ancient life. Now, each of these layers of rock are known to contain different types of fossils. Non-avian dinosaurs that we're going to study in this video series are found only in the Mesozoic era. The Mesozoic was further split into three periods. The Triassic period, named after the Trias layer of rocks in Germany, first distinguished by the German paleontologist Friedrich von Alberti in 1834. In Germany, these Trias rock layers are a set of three rock units, a layer of red rocks overlain by a gray limestone, which is overlaid by a dark gray and tan mudstone and sandstones, giving sort of a distinct three layers of rock in Germany. In fact, early dinosaurs are found in these upper layers of rocks in Germany, such as Plateosaurus. The next period is the Jurassic period, which is named after the Jura Mountains in the Alps. It was coined Jura Kalak by the famous explorer Alexander von Humboldt in 1795, but it came to be called Jurassic later on. It's for a layer of limestone rocks which preserve a very different group of fossils than the Triassic rocks known in the northern part of Germany. The last period of the Mesozoic era is the Cretaceous period, was named in 1822 by a Belgian geologist, Jean de Olemas de Halle, for the chalk layers around the city of Paris and correlated to the southern shores of England. Now, these white layers of limestone contain another group of fossils that were unlike those found in the Jurassic or Triassic layers. Now, while these early geologists knew that these layers were each representing different periods of Earth's history, they did not know the dates for these layers of rocks, all of which contain fossil dinosaurs that begin to be discovered in the 1800s across Europe. Here's the field notebook of Charlotte Muchausen, who drew the Mesozoic layers across Europe during a trip in the 1820s. Here we see the older rocks in her native Scotland in red, and the blue Jurassic layer of rocks correlate across the English Channel and down and up to the Jura Mountains of the south. And here in Paris, the younger layers of the Cretaceous and Cenozoic in the Paris Basin. Accompanying her on this trip was her good friend Joseph Leidy, who became the father of modern geology. In the 20th century, methods of dating actually allow geologists and paleontologists to apply dates to each of these subdivisions of rock units. So as we move through this course, I suggest that you memorize these dates, since we'll be referring to these periods frequently. Triassic period began 252 million years ago and ended 201 million years ago, at which time the Jurassic period began, which lasted until 145 million years ago, at which time the Cretaceous period began, which lasted until 66 million years ago. Thus, the entire Mesozoic era lasted from 252 million years ago to 66 million years ago. Note that these are the dates most recently calibrated by the International Commission on Stratigraphy, which revises the boundary dates as better dating studies are undertaken by scientists at various rock layer boundaries. In fact, you might have heard that the end of the Mesozoic era, the end of the Cretaceous period when the dinosaurs went extinct, was 65.5 million years ago. But recent calibrations on layers of rocks in Colorado have modified that to 66 million years ago. Dating techniques have advanced over the last 50 years, and paleontologists and geologists have traveled the world dating the boundaries between each of these rock layers. Each period of the Mesozoic era is represented by unique fossils and unique dinosaurs. Each boundary between periods represents a mass extinction event. The extinction of non-avian dinosaurs occurs at the end of the Cretaceous period, 66 million years ago. Now, despite lots of looking by lots of paleontologists, no non-avian dinosaur has been found above this layer of rocks. The following Cenozoic era, the modern life era, lacks any giant dinosaurs. All right, after watching this video, you should be able to name and order the three geological periods of the Mesozoic, the age of dinosaurs, and memorize their boundary dates.